This video will be a catch-up review of all that we've learned in the staff form so far. I'll point out some of the details and stuff that you have to remember as we're working on the staff form, and just kind of a little bits of information that will help you in practicing the staff. Again, I told you that Sifu preferred the rattan staff. This rattan staff has a skin on it. You can get skinless as well, where it's kind of like just down to the bare rattan. The skin version is a little bit sticky on cold mornings, but it has a fairly slick surface, and it's pretty good. This staff is about a quarter inch and an eighth to about inch and a quarter. It has that much flexibility. Now, if you don't have rattan staff, shouldn't keep you from practicing the staff form. You can use basically any kind of long pole. You can go get a closet pole that works. I use a closet pole also for many years. This staff is like a wushu staff. It's a tapered wax wood, and it starts at about an inch and an eighth and tapers to about 3/4 inch. It has about the same amount of flexibility, and it has very smooth wood that kind of gets a nice patina after you use it for a long time. It's just slightly heavier than the rattan staff, but you can do all the same action with it. The only thing on this staff is when you're doing the sliding on this side, the left side, right side will be the thick side, left side will be the thin side. So you can kind of see that difference a little bit, but it still slides the same. And the actions for sliding all the various types of staff are exactly the same. I just made this staff. It's a comes off a hole handle that I bought at the hardware store years ago, and it's fiberglass. And so the reason I made this staff is so I could leave it outside in the rain and forget about it and just have it kind of stored outside. And whenever I'm out working around and I think of something I want to do with the staff or something, I could pick it up and play with it. Again, it doesn't have very little flex to it. It's about the same weight as the rattan staff. And the reason why I'm showing all this is that you can basically practice with any pole that you find. So the action of the stick generated from the body is going to be similar. And there's one more way that you can train. You can train actually without a staff. And so what you're doing when you're training without the staff is you're generating the root and the body turn and everything and the timing. So you can just kind of pretend that you have a staff. And this exercise is actually pretty good, because as you're forced to perform with this imaginary staff, you can concentrate on the correct body movement. And you're having to coordinate your arms just like you would. And you try to imagine the weight of that staff as you're performing it with your hands. And so again, the looseness of that arm movement is exactly the same as if you have a staff. So let's go into the review. I'm going to move these out of the way so they're not in the photo. So as I do the form, I'm going to kind of do it slow, and I'm going to point out the things that we need to remember as you're performing the staff. And again, there's not only one way to perform the staff. Different practitioners come up with their own interpretation of the basic form and have different ways of manipulating the staff, and you're free to find your own way. What I'm showing you is what I've discovered over years and years of practice on my preferred method of performing Lien Ying staff form. So in the beginning, you do the flip into the opening here. Remember to do the slide and then step to the right. And then the overhead block into the crane stance. Now on the overhead block, you notice that right arm is vertical, left arm is horizontal, and that creates the staff at a 45 degree. You can change the angle of the staff by moving this arm less away from vertical, and you have more of a horizontal overhead block. It's up to you. The distance from here to here can vary. You can be more extended to guard. Like if you have more of a horizontal block, you can extend the staff all the way to this here. So there's a variation on the mount that you have that. Also, when you're walking the circle, ideally look towards the center. As you do the circle, and then change back to looking forward as you do the overhead strike. So again, from the very beginning, and again, I remind you to start a little bit to the right of center, so that as you do the double step and turn, you have room to do that. If you start too much in the center, you're going to be kind of not enough distance. Depending on your perimeter, so start over to the right a little bit. So from here, the attention, focus, get ready, and then the flip. Okay, you remember to do the slide, step, step, and then again on this drag here. I think a lot of people are going to be tending to do this, and what I encouraged in the beginning was to slide this foot back, keep your body square, so you do the reverse force for the power of the strike rather than torquing for the power of the strike. So the flip, the slide, two, torque, step, step, stay square, overhead, walk in a circle, look towards the middle, overhead strike. Remember to have the staff out in the middle of your arm rather than your armpit. Okay? Strike, strike, step in, strike to the left. Low block, about 2 inches off the ground. The low sweeping, and then the pull back, body square. And then overhead strike, turn to the side horse. Okay, the pendulum swing, you're gonna slide back, judge the amount of distance, depending on how high your arm is, for the strike. Power is the flip at the end. In the crescent block here, I forgot to tell you that the body is turned 12 o'clock in this direction as you're doing the block. And then you turn back to 9 o'clock for the horizontal strike. And that's where we begin the lesson into the turn. And then the low cross stance, deflected block. So let's do this at full speed. So that should catch you up to where we are. If you have any questions, be sure to put them in the comments and I'll answer them for you. Okay, thank you.